Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're talking about the P0420 and P0430 engine codes. A P0420 or 430 engine code is going to read something along the lines of catalyst system efficiency below threshold for bank one or bank two. Now, when it says catalyst system, it is referring to the catalytic converter on your vehicle. However, a P0420 or 430 engine code doesn't necessarily mean that your catalytic converter is bad. There are a number of other causes and things that can cause you to get a P0420 or 430 engine code. So in this video, we're going to go ahead and break down what a P0420 engine code means. We're going to talk about signs and symptoms to watch for, how to diagnose it, and most importantly, what the common causes are and how to fix those problems so that you aren't throwing parts and money unnecessarily at this engine code. So as I mentioned, a P0420 means that your catalyst system efficiency is below the threshold. The way that catalytic converters work is we have an upstream and a downstream O2 sensor. Oxygen sensor. The upstream O2 sensor sits before the catalytic converter and the downstream one sits after the catalytic converter. As exhaust gases pass through both of these oxygen sensors and through the catalytic converter, the oxygen sensors take a reading. So it takes a reading before and after it passes through the catalytic converter. And if the catalytic converter isn't functioning properly, you are going to get an engine code like P0420, letting you know that the catalytic converter is not doing its job and cleaning up the exhaust gases like it should. This could mean that your catalytic converter's bad, but it also could mean that you have issues with other things like the oxygen sensors as well. But ultimately, what this means is that the readings between the two oxygen sensors don't agree on what they should be, and the exhaust gases, therefore, might not be adequately getting cleaned. First off, let's go ahead and talk about symptoms that you'll get along with a P0420 engine code. The first thing that you're going to get is a check engine light, and if you use a code scanner, you're going to get the obvious P0420 engine code. In addition to that, you might also get a raw exhaust smell where your exhaust gases smell like rotten eggs. You could also be experiencing poor fuel economy. You could have misfires or power loss, or your engine could potentially go into limp mode. In addition to that, you could also be having issues with your air to fuel ratios. If your car is running too rich or too lean, it could also trigger a P0420. So with all of those potential symptoms, let's go ahead and talk about what the most common causes of a P0420 engine code are. The first thing is an issue with your catalytic converter. Naturally, over time, catalytic converters do wear out and they can potentially clog up or even fully hollow out. If your catalytic converter clogs up, you're going to have a number of performance-related issues. And if it completely hollows out, then you're going to be smelling rotten exhaust gases and be getting engine codes related to the oxygen sensor saying that the readings are off. The next thing that could cause it is exhaust leaks. If you have a leak in your exhaust, whether it's from a cracked exhaust manifold or having a hole in one of your exhaust pipes, that could also cause a P0420 code. So you'll want to make sure you inspect your exhaust system because any leaks within the exhaust system could throw off the readings from the oxygen sensors too. That brings us to the third thing here, and that is the oxygen sensors themselves. If your oxygen sensors fail, they could be sending incorrect readings or not be sending a reading at all to the engine's computer, which would trigger one of these codes, but it would also typically trigger as code specifically for that oxygen sensor. And then the fourth thing here is some other underlying issues with your car. Like I mentioned, if your air to fuel ratios are off, you could be running too rich or too lean, and issues like that could give you a P0420 code as well. But you would also typically see a potential engine code for your air to fuel ratios with that as well. So after discussing the causes, now let's talk about what you can do to diagnose what the actual problem or cause of the issue is, and therefore what you need to fix. The first thing to do is start with a code reader and to scan it for your codes. Of course, you're gonna have a P0420 engine code, but you're also gonna wanna see what other engine codes are present because that could point you to a different underlying issue that could be causing this. What I always recommend doing is clearing the codes, resetting them, and going and driving around for 10 or 15 minutes to see if the code comes back. If it doesn't come back, it might have just been a fluke and it's not a real issue. And so you wanna make sure that it's an actual problem before you take it to a repair shop. The second thing that you're gonna wanna do is inspect the exhaust system. You'll wanna take a look at the exhaust manifold and see if you can see any cracks or leaks there. And then you'll want to inspect all of the exhaust piping as well to make sure there aren't any holes in it. Third, you'll want to test the oxygen sensors. You can use a scan tool if you have advanced enough of a scan tool to actually monitor the voltage readings coming from both O2 sensors. The upstream O2 sensor should fluctuate a bit, but the downstream sensor should stay relatively constant. So via a scan tool, you can monitor the readings coming from the O2 sensors to see if there's anything funky looking from those. And additionally, a fourth thing that you can do with a scan tool as well is to check your air to fuel ratios. You can analyze fuel trim data with a scan tool to see if the engine is running too rich or too lean. So guys, that covers it for our problems and diagnostics there. Ultimately, this problem is gonna come down to an issue with your catalytic converter, an issue with your oxygen sensors, or an issue with your exhaust system having some type of leak in it. And then lastly, you might notice an issue coming from some other underlying problem, but in those instances, you typically will get a check engine light and error codes coming for what that other problem is. So ultimately, your biggest friend here is gonna be a scan tool that can measure and read all the diagnostic data that we're talking about here and can help point you into the right direction. If your oxygen sensors are bad, there is a chance that you will get an engine code for the oxygen sensors as well. But depending if they've completely failed or not, you might not get a code for those. Ultimately, you'll want to go ahead and try to test those or measure those to make sure you're actually getting readings from them and that they're actually working as they should. And then a last tip here is before you go replacing your catalytic converter thinking that's the problem, you're going to want to go ahead and fix any other underlying problems that you have. Otherwise, you're going to risk ruining your brand new catalytic converter. With that being said, let's talk about a few of the costs of these various different components. A catalytic converter can run you anywhere from $200 to $2,000+, depending on what your vehicle is and whether you go OEM or aftermarket. Oxygen sensors typically cost between $50 to $150 each, and most cars have two of them, some have more. Exhaust leaks can range from just an easy, simple welding job all the way up to $500+ for a new exhaust system or a certain new section of the exhaust system. So ultimately, proper diagnostics and really following our list there to determine what is the problem is really helpful to make sure you don't waste money replacing parts unnecessarily. Anyways, guys, that covers it on our video on P0420 and P0430 engine codes. With a little bit of diagnostic work, you can go ahead and crack down what's causing this and hopefully fix it without letting repair shops take you for a ride. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for more DIY diagnostic repair and maintenance help for your vehicles.